thank you so much for having me. I really have been looking forward to this for quite some time. So again, really an honor. As you heard, my name is Lena Nasserdeen. I'm the CEO and founder of Rise Up For You, but I didn't always start that way. So as mentioned, I started as a performer. So I used to tour the world internationally as a singer and a dancer. Does anyone like to sing or dance? Ooh. Usually people are afraid to say anything because they think I'm going to trick them and call on them. Don't worry, I'm not going to do that. And if you know anything about performing and singing, you know that center stage is the place that you want to be. So when I was a performer, every time I used to walk into the room, I always got the center stage spot. They call it the diva spotlight. But I was never, ever the best singer in the room. Okay, I want you to think about that for a second, okay? So I always got the center stage spot, but I was never the best singer in the room. There were always three or four individuals that can sing me out of the water. They had a 3.5 octave range, I had a 2.5 octave range. They had parents that were celebrities, I sang in my garage growing up. And yet I still got that center stage spot. And they used to come up to me and they used to say, Netta, how do I get that spot? And I used to say, you know, everything you need is already inside of you. You actually have better technique than me. The only difference is the way that I show up in the room. Now, fast forward 7 years later, and I become the executive of an education corporation. I had professionals that had PhDs, master's degrees, bachelor's, you name it, amazing, technically, struggling with the same thing. Struggling with perfectionist mindset, imposter syndrome, really stepping into their success. They had all the technique they needed, and yet they were constantly getting in their way. Can anybody connect or resonate with that? Yeah, quite a few of us. So I started to ask myself, okay, I have 200 team members under me, I'm 27 years old, and the majority of them are struggling to push their potential and really be their best, not because they don't have the skill, not because they're not qualified to do the job, but because they're getting in their own way. So I started to ask myself, okay, if I have two resumes in front of me, okay, they have the exact same skill, what makes one person more successful than others? If I have two companies in front of me, they have the same service, they do the same thing, how come some organizations move further and go farther faster than another organization? And at the end of the day, and now I run my own company, my team and I realize no matter what industry you're in, no matter what role you're in, people around the world, organizations around the world, they want to know, how do I be seen? How do I be heard? And how do I become relevant? And that's what we're going to talk about today. I'm going to break down these three things for you. So, can you see that? Ooh, I like how it's like split screen. That's awesome. Okay, so tip number one, and this is in your book as well. I believe yesterday you heard a speaker named William, right? And he talked about personal like values and brands. Okay, we're going to touch on that a little bit. I always say be the billboard people stop to see. Now, I'm going to be honest. I got here a couple hours ago. I was in the room. I was observing. I was watching. I do that because I want to know what's my audience and who am I connected to, like who's in the room. And I will tell you that I speak on stage around the world a lot. I just came back from a 3-month tour back in Vegas after 3 months in Dubai, North Carolina, all over the place. And every time I walk into a room, I see that the majority of individuals like yourself, you let go of the power of your presence. You don't realize how important you are in a room. And the amount of people that I see that walk into a room or walk in the hallway as if they don't exist. And you forget that actually every single person in this room is impacting and influencing just by being in the room today. That you are a walking billboard. So there's small things that we can do that can really make an impact. Because you have to remember, within the 10th of a second, somebody is making a judgment. Not somebody, all of us, according to research, are making a judgment about the individual before they even open their mouth, right? So before I even like open my mouth, the second I walked on stage, you're already judging my dress and my shoes and my bracelets and whatever I'm wearing, right? We all do that. But it is just astonishing the amount of people that don't realize how important they are as an individual contributor in the room. So I'm gonna share with you, this is the easiest step, just a few little strategies that you can implement literally tomorrow, okay? So I always say, be the billboard people stop to see. Step one, show up to level up. Raise your hand if you're wearing a bright, solid color in this room right now. Five of you, okay? Awesome. Now, the reason why I say that is because color, remember this, color starts conversation. Color starts conversation. So if you wanna be seen, do you know how many people have come up to me today and said, I love your outfit, and then we start talking, thank you so much, where'd you get it from, Shein, if you wanna know, right? Okay, so color starts conversation. And it also gets people to look and be like, oh, who is that person? So obviously, I see the beautiful lady in the back with the yellow shirt, and then next to her is wearing orange, and next to her is wearing green. Go ahead, power table back there, okay? Okay, so I see that in a room full of people, my eye goes towards that color, right? So now I see them. It starts conversation. Now, the tragedy is that most people don't want to be seen. They want to hide. So we often wear black, we wear brown, we wear neutral colors, okay? But think about it. What's one color that you can wear that can really stand out in a room when you network, when you go to work, when you have important meetings, whatever it is, that's gonna help you emulate a certain emotion or energy? Okay, so that's number one, and you can do that tomorrow. I want you to think about what kind of energy do you wanna emulate as a professional and as an individual. Now, I love black. It's my favorite color. Half my closet is black. But I realize that sometimes when I wear that color, it creates a closed off environment around me, right? Like a box. So I wear bright colors so that people can come in and talk to me and create more warmth. So that's number one. I'm still on the billboard. Okay, showing up as the billboard, show up to level up, foster an open energy. Okay, so when I was 27 years old, I told you I used to be an executive. I had 200 team members under me. I thought I was the most amazing executive ever. I'm like, I got this, right? But not one person would walk into my office. Not one. I had an open door policy. So I started to ask, like, how come no one's like coming in to talk to me? I want to coach, I want to lead, I want to mentor. And then one day, somebody said, well, you're kind of intimidating. And I said, no, that's not true. And then a little bit later, another person said, well, you're kind of intimidating. I said, well, I don't think so. But I wanted to grow, I wanted to learn, so I decided to do an anonymous survey. Out of two, someone said, uh-oh, that's how I felt, okay? Out of 200 team members, 75% said I was intimidating, not relatable, and I looked mad all the time. That was a rough night for me. But I learned, okay, that the way that I felt energetically was actually not what was coming across. Has anyone ever heard of the resting face? Yeah, I'm sure we have. So I realized that even though in the inside I felt warm and fuzzy and butterflies and all I wanted to do was help people, something energetically was not coming across that way. And the majority of my team, numbers don't lie, right? The majority of my team were getting something completely different. And I didn't want my energy to permeate that. I wanted my energy to permeate warmth, kindness, leadership, openness. So I had to adjust, okay? I had to ask myself, what do I wanna emote? What are the emotions and the values that I want them to see in me, okay? And also in my languaging. I wanted to make sure that I had kind languaging that was clear, not subservient, and not full of fillers. Has anyone ever heard of subservient and filler languaging? Okay, so for example, when you raise your hand in your meeting and you say, so I have a question, okay? So being able to cut that all out and raising your hand, whatever it is, and saying, I have a question I'd like to talk about. Really clear and really crisp.